All right, we can begin.
Yes, we can begin.
Okay. Om Jnana Timirandasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha.
Recording in progress.
Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripasindubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. So this morning we were hearing how Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu took all the devotees to Gundicha to clean the temple. This is the day before Rath Yatra. It happens. The cleaning of the Gundicha temple takes place one day before the Rath Yatra. The deities, Lord Jagannath, Lord Baladev, and Subhadra Devi, they have been in quarantine for 2 weeks. After the bathing ceremony, on the day of the bathing ceremony, that from that day on, they were in quarantine for 14 days. So during those 14 days, the deities are repainted, because with the bathing which they have, it takes off a lot of the paint, a lot of the color from their bodies, so they have to be repainted. So this morning we heard how Lord Chaitanya came to the Gundicha temple with hundreds of devotees, and together they all cleaned the whole place. They cleaned the ceiling, they cleaned the walls, they cleaned inside the temple, they cleaned inside the rooms, and they cleaned outside. Then we were discussing this morning, we were hearing how cleaning the temple is not different from cleaning the heart. So within the heart we have many impurities, a lot of contamination, and we have to remove that through devotional service. So we were hearing how many different kinds of activities cause contamination in the heart, different kinds of material activities, even though they may appear to be spiritual, but they have some materialistic influences, and it becomes a contamination in the heart.
Today, 陶醉了内心的污染。他们虽然表面上好像是灵性的活动，但是因为受到了物质的影响，因此就给内心带来了污垢。
If we do things like cultivate meditation on the Brahman and the desire for oneness, or we may have desire for yoga siddhis, or we may engage in speculative philosophy, all of these things are not good for the devotee who's trying to advance.
比如说像冥想 Brahman, 冥想梵，或者是培养一元论的哲学，或者是想要达到瑜伽的完美，或者是培养哲学的推敲，这些对于我们的灵性进步都没有好处。
So, one of the problems, one of the things, the dirty things, the anarthas, the things which we don't want in the heart, is something called jiva himsa, which means to be envious of other living entities.
内心的一个问题叫做 jiva himsa, 就是对其他的生物体产生嫉妒。
And this kind of mentality, this has the effect of stopping the preaching of Krishna consciousness.
那这种心态呢，就使得一个人停止了传播 Krishna 知觉。
Yeah, preaching work is for the benefit of others, but some people are ignorant of the benefits of devotional service.
传播工作是为了给其他人带来好处，但是有的人呢，他们对于奉献服务的好处一无所知。
So we have to educate them by preaching about how devotional service is so good for us.
所以我们就需要向他们进行传播，来告诉他们，教导他们，奉献服务对我们是有很大的好处。
And if somebody stops preaching, and if they just want to sit down in a quiet place, and they just want to be engaged in meditation, or they say, I'm just going to chant, so that kind of activity, that is another kind of anartha, another kind of dirty thing in the heart.
倘若有谁停止了传播工作，就坐在一个僻静的地方，在那里冥想，或者是在那里独自的唱诵，这种活动也是内心的一个 anartha, 一个不洁。
Yeah, just another kind of material activity.
是另外一种物质的活动。
So a devotee should not make compromises with people who are not devotees.
奉献者跟那些非奉献者不能当妥协。
And if somebody acts like they're a guru or a mystic yogi or some kind of miracle man, then they may be cheaters and they just cheat the innocent people.
倘若有人呢，他就这个孤独而自居，或者是以玄秘的瑜伽师自居，或者是以这个魔术能够行使魔术的人自居，那么这是一类欺骗活动。
So all these kind of activities like that, being, you know, being a mystic yogi or doing miracles or being a guru to get money from people, these things are just likedust and straw and sand in the heart.
所有这一类下述的下面的活动，做一个玄秘的瑜伽师，或者是为了赚钱而去当孤儒、灵性导师，或者是行使这些玄妙的魔术、魔力活动，这些都好像是尘土、稻草、沙粒。
So Lord Chaitanya personally showed us how careful we have to be to clean the heart and to clean the temple.
柴丹尼亚就以身示范，教导人们，我们在清洁内心和清洁庙宇的时候，应当多么的小心。
He cleaned the temple first, and then he cleaned it again the second time, and the second time he cleaned it more thoroughly.
他带领奉献者们清理了整座庙宇，接着他又再次和所有奉献者又再次清理了一遍。而且这一遍是更加彻底的清理了。
So there's many different obstacles in the path of devotional service. So we have to clean the temple very carefully.
在公爱服务的道路上有许许多多的障碍，因此呢，我们应当非常仔细小心地来清理庙宇。
Lord Chaitanya would use his own cloth to clean the temple. Lord Chaitanya wanted to see that the temple was properly cleaned. He wanted the temple to be like clean marble.Because when the marble is very clean, then it has a nice cooling effect.
Chaitanya 希望这个庙宇的大理石是非常的洁净、一尘不染的，因为大理石清洁之后，它就显得非常的有清凉作用。
Yeah. In order to make our mind peaceful, we have to clean everything very carefully so that no desires, no material desires can disturb us.
让我们保持心意平和，我们必须小心翼翼地清理一切，好让我们内心不再有任何的物质欲望。
So even though we clean away the dirty things, sometimes something remains and then it grows, it's very small, but then it grows more and more.
一边有时候我们已经清理了，但是仍然清理的这些污垢，但是仍然会有一些剩余的污垢，而且这个会一点一点的污垢会越来越扩大扩散。
So Lord Chaitanya wanted to remove all of these things fully, so they wouldn't come and disturb.
柴丹尼亚希望把他们彻底的、全部的都清除的一干二净，好让他们不再来打扰我们。
Then when the heart is clean, then we can invite Krishna to come and sit down in our heart.
我们内心洁净之后，都可以邀请主 Krishna 来到我们坐在我们的内心。
Then we should have a festival, and we should invite people to come and chant Hare Krishna and give everyone prasadam.
我们应当举行节日，并且邀请人们来唱诵 Hare Krishna， 并且派发布沙的地狱。
So Lord Chaitanya used to teach by his personal example, and everyone who helped to spread Krishna consciousness, they have a responsibility.
柴丹尼亚就以身作则。
Lord Chaitanya was praising somebody who worked hard and he chastised somebody who didn't work hard. So Srila Prabhupada says that those who are spiritual teachers, they should learn from Lord Chaitanya how to teach others by their own example.
Srila Prabhupada 对此就评论说，一位灵性导师应当学习主柴丹尼亚如何通过他们个人的榜样来教导别人。
Yeah, if Lord Chaitanya saw somebody cleaning the temple very nicely and taking out all the unwanted things, he would be very pleased.
Chaitanya 倘若看见每个人把庙宇都打扫得干干净净，把所有的脏东西拿出去的时候，他内心就会感到非常的满意。
So this cleaning of the heart, this is like the stage of anatta nivritti. Anatta means all the things we don't want, and nivritti is to remove them all.
这种清理内心的程序被称为 anatta nivritti. Anatta 的意思就是说不想要的事物， nivritti 的意思是去除。
So the cleaning of the Gundicha temple is to let us know how the heart should be cleaned.
清理贡地城庙就要教育我们，让我们知道我们应当清理我们的内心。
And we should invite Lord Krishna to come and sit in our heart.In a heart, there should not be any disturbance for him. So after they cleaned the Gundicha temple, then Lord Chaitanya took some devotees to a temple nearby, a temple of Lord Nrsingadev, and they cleaned that temple also.
清理完巩俐城庙之后，卢采丹亚又带领了一些奉献者去旁边的尼什哈庙宇，他们也把这所庙宇打扫得干干净净。
So, Lord Chaitanya had all the devotees chanting and dancing, and he was Lord Chaitanya was like a lion.Dancing in the middle.
Chaitanya 就让所有的奉献者唱歌起舞，主 Chaitanya 就像一头雄狮一样在他们中间。
And Lord Chaitanya, when he would dance, he would show symptoms of ecstasy. His body would sweat and he would tremble, and he would tears from his eyes and so many things like that.
就柴丹尿跳舞的时候，他浑身上下展示出极乐的征兆，他会浑身流汗、颤抖、泪如雨泻等等。
And Lord Chaitanya, tears from his eyes were like the water coming from a syringe. It was washing people, everybody nearby.
当他跳舞的时候，他眼中的泪水就像喷泉一样，会打湿出。
So Lord Chaitanya, when the tears would come from his eyes, it would be so much water, he would wash all the devotees who were nearby. They would all be soaking wet with the tears coming from his eyes like rain.
眼中的泪水是如此的，他的泪水流得如此的多，以至于站在他周围的奉献者都被他的泪水打湿了，就像他们被雨水淋湿一样。
So Lord Chaitanya liked to hear the chanting of Swarup Damodar, and when he would sing, when Swarup Damodar would sing, then Lord Chaitanya would chant and jump and dance very high.In ecstasy.
主柴丹尼亚特别喜欢听扎鲁巴达姆达尔的唱诵。当扎鲁巴达姆达尔唱歌的时候，主柴丹尼亚妈巴布他会跳舞，会在极乐当中，在跳到半空当中。
So Lord Chaitanya would chant and dance for some time, and when he was chanting, the earth would shake.Because Lord Chaitanya was dancing so vigorously, the whole earth planet would shake. And when Lord Chaitanya was there, he would ask Swarup Damodar to sing, because Swarup Damodar would sing very nicely. Lord Chaitanya liked his singing and chanting. And when he would sing, then Lord Chaitanya would dance, and he'd jump very high in ecstasy. Then Lord Chaitanya asked for Advaita Acharya's son, Gopal, to come, and he asked him to dance. But when Gopal was dancing, he was dancing in ecstasy, but at one point he fell to the ground and he was unconscious. So when Gopal fainted, Advaita Acharya, his father, was very worried, and he put the son on his lap. Then Advaita Acharya could see his son was not even breathing. So Advaita Acharya became very worried, and he began to chant to Lord Nrisingadev, Namaste Narasinghaya Prahlad. He was chanting like that, praying to Lord Nrisingadev. And the boy, still he didn't come back to consciousness. Then Advaita Acharya and the other devotees, they began to cry. Then Lord Chaitanya came and he put his hand on the chest of the boy and he said, Gopal, stand up. And as soon as Gopal heard Lord Chaitanya say that, he immediately came back to consciousness and he stood up. So after taking some rest, then Lord Chaitanya and all the devotees went to take their baths in the sea. So then Lord Chaitanya went into the garden with all the devotees and they sat down and then they brought Mahaprasadam and they distributed Mahaprasadam to everyone. And they brought enough prasadam for 500 people. They had all kinds of cakes and sweet rice and vegetables.
And
So Lord Chaitanya was very happy to see so many nice preparations had been offered. So there were many great devotees there. Many devotees had come from Bengal, and all the devotees who lived there in Jagannath Puri. So there were many people. So they sat down and began to get ready to take prasadam. And Lord Chaitanya would call out, Haridas, Haridas. And then you would see Haridas. Haridas would be quite far away, not nearby, quite distance away. But he would say, let Lord Chaitanya take his lunch with the devotees. I cannot sit down with you. I am a very sinful person. And then Haridas said, Govinda, Govinda will give me prasadam later, not in the temple, outside the temple.
Haridas said,
So when Lord Chaitanya heard this, then Lord Chaitanya didn't call Haridas again, because he knew Haridas already made up his mind what he was going to do. So just like the devotees were taking their lunch in Jagannath Puri, it was just like Lord Krishna taking his lunch in the forest of Vrindavan. Remembering the pastimes of Lord Krishna, awakened the love in Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So Lord Chaitanya told the devotees, they said, give all the sweet rice and cakes and all these nice preparations, you give them to all the devotees, and just give me the whatever little rice is there with the little pieces of vegetable. So this Lord Chaitanya is a sannyasi, he wanted to eat very simple. And he knew what kind of preparations to give to the other devotees. So he would go and give very nice opulent prasadam to all the devotees. But then Jagadananda brought prasadam, and he brought all the best kind of preparations, and he put them all on Lord Chaitanya's plate. And when Lord Chaitanya saw that they'd given him all the opulent prasadam, Lord Chaitanya got a little angry. But when the preparations were put on the plate of Lord Chaitanya, he would be satisfied. He would just accept, okay. Lord Chaitanya would look at the food for some time, and then he would remember Jagadananda, and he would be afraid. If he knew if he didn't eat, then Jagadananda would be angry at him.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就这样盯着他盘子里的食物看了一会儿，因为他有点惧，畏惧Jagadananda，最后他也吃了。
Lord Chaitanya knew if he didn't eat the nice food which Jagadananda had put on his plate, then Jagadananda would not eat the food given to him. And Jagadananda, he was just a tourist, you know. He didn't have a regular job or anything.
A tourist, 他只是一个旅游者, 他没有固定的工作。
No. Lord Chaitanya was afraid if he didn't eat it, then Jagadananda would also not eat. Jagadananda would fast. So Lord Chaitanya didn't want Jagadananda to fast, so Lord Chaitanya would eat some of the prasadam. And then another devotee, Swarup Damodar, came and he brought very, very nice sweets, the best kind of sweets, and he brought them to Lord Chaitanya. And he said to Lord Chaitanya, just take a little of this Mahaprasadam and see how Lord Jagannath has taken it. So Lord Chaitanya would have to take a little and taste it. And then it would happen again and again. Swarup Damodar and Jagadananda, they would come and they would bring the best prasadam and they would ask Lord Chaitanya, just try this, take a little of this. 然后主就听了斯拉舒克达摩达尔这番话之后呢，他就吃了一点点。但是斯拉舒克达摩达尔和扎嘎达南达呢，他们把一次又一次的拿了美味的食物给主，让他就告诉主，你就吃一点点，你就吃一点点好了。So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya was sitting there with Lord Chaitanya, and he was watching, and he was laughing at how Jagadananda and Swarup Damodar were getting Lord Chaitanya to eat. Lord Chaitanya, he also wanted to offer the best prasadam to Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. So he had the servers put nice food on the plate for Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya. And when they saw Bhattacharya sitting with all this nice prasadam, they said, just see, he said, before this Bhattacharya, that he would never eat such nice food as this.
And 丰盛的种类繁多的一流的 prasada 上乘的 prasada 的时候，他们就说，你看啊，萨尔邦班的查尔以前他这绝对不会吃这么多这些好吃的食物。
Because previously Bhattacharya he'd been a smarter Brahman. Smarter Brahman means somebody who follows all the Vedic rules and regulations.
以前 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 是一位 smarter Brahman, smarter Brahman. Smarter Brahman 的意思是严格遵守伟大的规范原则的 Brahman.
But they're on the mundane platform.
但是他们是处在世俗的层面上。
And they cannot understand that prasadam is transcendental. And they cannot understand that Govinda is the original personality of Godhead. And they cannot understand a Vaishnava is a liberated person. So most of these so-called brahmanas are like that. They cannot understand these things. They think the absolute truth is impersonal. And they think that a person who is born in a particular caste, like if somebody is born a brahmana, then they must be a brahmana.
诞生在特定的种姓家族中的人，比如说诞生在婆罗门家庭的人就是婆罗门了。
And they think you can't change that until you die and take another birth.
他们认为一个人的种姓是不会改变的，直到这个人死去，他都保持着自己的种姓。
So Bhattacharya originally he was like that. He thought all these things. He was a smarter Brahmin. He was a Mayavadi.
以前就是这样的人，他是一位 smart Brahmana, smart Brahman, 他是一位 Mayavad.
But by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, he'd been converted, and now he was taking all the nice prasadam of the Vaishnavas.
但是即使主 Chaitanya 的仁慈，他已经改变了，然后他就也荣耀了这些非常好吃的 prasadam.
So Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya said, you're right. He said, I was a less intelligent logician.
So Bhattacharya 就说道，您说的都对，我就是一个智慧缺乏的逻辑学家。
But by your grace, by your mercy, I've received this perfection.
依着您的仁慈，我达到了这种完美。
If it was not for Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, it's only by his mercy that he changed me. I was like a crow, and he has changed me into a Garuda. Garuda, who could be so kind, so merciful? Only Lord Chaitanya.
Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 就说，他这么仁慈，他把一只乌鸦给转变成了 Garuda。除了主 Chaitanya， 谁还会这么仁慈呢
？And then Bhattacharya said, "I was in the association of logicians, and these people—they're just like jackals."
Bhattacharya 说，我一直与那些逻辑学家为伴。这些逻辑学家呢，他们就像胡狼。
So before, all I could do was say "biu biu," just like the jackals here in Mayapur. Every evening, you can hear them, "biu biu." He said, "But now, with the same mouth, I can chant the name Krishna and Hari."
就是马普有很多胡狼，他们一到夜里都会发 是由于直柴太院的仁慈，现在他用同一张嘴，他现在唱出了 Krishna Hari 的名字。
Before I was in the association of these people, these logicians, and they're all non-devotees. But now I am in the ocean of nectar in the association of devotees.
以前我是和所有这些逻辑学家作伴的，和这些逻辑学家，他们全都是非奉献者。但是现在呢，我却是在和奉献者的联谊当中呢，我沉浸在甘露的海洋波涛中。
Because we get attracted by the opulence of the material energy, and then we forget about our relationship with Krishna.
因为我们被物质的富裕，这种绚烂的物质富裕深深的吸引了，所以我们把 Krishna 抛到九霄云外了。
We forget that the goal of life for a human being is to understand God, Vishnu. Human life is meant for this. We have to go through all the austerities to get free from sense gratification.
人体的生命就是为了这些，要经历苦行，然后去摆脱感官享乐。
Materialistic people, they take guidance from other blind people, and they cannot get any good result.
物质主义者，他们以那些盲人为向导，他们不会达到任何好的结果。
So he doesn't know, he has to be controlled by the material nature. So the material world is just one fraction, it's 1/4 compared to the spiritual world, which is 3/4.
物质世界和灵性世界相比只是四分之一，而灵性世界占大部分，四分之三。
They don't materialistic people don't know anything about the spiritual world. They just think only about the material world.
物质主义者对灵性世界是，一无所知，他们满脑子都是物质世界。
They don't take instructions from the scriptures.
他们从来不去向经典求助。
We have to see everything through the eyes of the scriptures. So Lord Chaitanya told Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, he said, from your previous birth, you have been in Krishna consciousness.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 就对 Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya 说，你上一世你就已经有 Krishna 知觉了。
And because you have so much love for Krishna, by your association, we are also developing love for Krishna.
由于你对 Krishna 的爱，仅仅通过跟您联谊，我们也自动发展了 Krishna 知觉。
So we can see Lord Chaitanya's kindness, that he always tries to increase the glory or the name of a devotee. He wants them to be recognized. So Lord Chaitanya then got all the remnants of the food offered to Jagannath, all the cakes and the sweet rice, and he called all the other devotees and he would distribute it to all of them. So Advaita Acharya was sitting with Lord Nityananda and they were taking prasadam together.
Advaita Acharya 和 Nityananda 他俩是
And they began to make a, they began to joke with each other and say things to each other, which apparently are not very nice, but it was actually with a very deep meaning, a special meaning. So Advaita Acharya said, you see, he said, you see, I'm sitting in line with an unknown mendicant, and I'm eating with him.
Advaita Acharya 就开始说话了，他说呀，我跟一个这个，我跟一个来历不明的一个乞丐乞士并肩并排的坐在一起。
Yeah, I'm eating with him.
而且呢，我还跟他一起共进这个午餐。
So I don't know what kind of destination I will get in the future.
那我就不知道我未来会去什么样的目的地了。
So this was Advaita Acharya. He was up, it appears like he's criticizing Lord Nityananda.
Advaita Acharya 这番话的表面上好像是在批评。
Because Lord Nityananda, he's like an unknown mendicant. They don't know, well, they don't really know where he came, where he comes from.
Nityananda 呢，他就好像是一个来历不明的一个乞士一样，因为没有人知道主 Nityananda 来自何方。
Then he said, Advaita said, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he's.And he's a sannyasi, he's in the renounced order of life. So he doesn't recognize anything wrong. He doesn't see any discrepancies, he doesn't see any faults.
Vidacharya 又继续说 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 是处在生命的气绝阶层。因此呢，他并没有认出有什么问题，有什么错误在里面。
Yeah, a sannyasi, he can eat food from anywhere and everywhere.
一位托钵僧，他可以吃，任何来自任何地方的食物，并且一位 sannyasi 也可以在所有地方都可以随便的在任何地方进食。
Advaita Acharya says, according to Shastra, sannyasis can go to eat at anybody's house.
Advaita Acharya 说。依据经典的观点，一位 sannyasi 托钵僧可以在任何人的家中就餐。
But Advaita said, I'm a householder and I'm a brahmana. So for a householder brahmana, you cannot eat like that. That kind of eating is very wrong.
Advaita Acharya 说，可是我是一位居士，那对于一位居士来说呢，这样去。
Yeah, Advaita Acharya said, it's not proper for a householder to eat food, to take their meals with those who we don't know about their previous birth.
Advaita Acharya 说，对于居士来说，和那些来历不明的人，知道他们上一世是什么，是谁的人。一起吃饭是非常有问题的。
We don't know about their family, we don't know about their character, their behavior.
我们也不知道他的家庭来历，也不知道他的品格，不知道他的行为。
So Lord Nityananda, he replied to Advaita Acharya, because it appears like Advaita Acharya was criticizing Lord Nityananda.
Nityananda 就开始就回击 Advaita Acharya 了，因为表面上呢 ，Advaita Acharya 是在抨击他。
So he says to Advaita Acharya, he said, "You are a teacher of impersonal monism."
那 Nityananda 帕布就对他说，你是一个非人格的一元论哲学的老师。
So the conclusion of your all your knowledge and all your study will not help you in devotional service.
那么你的所有这些知识，你的所有这些研究的学问，它的结论对于奉爱服务都没有任何帮助。
And anybody who takes part in your kind of philosophy, in your impersonal monistic philosophy, then all they know about is the Brahman.
任何人参加学习你的哲学，你的非人格的一元论的哲学，最后他们只接受了 Brahman 饭。
Actually, one who is a impersonal monist, they don't believe in God.
事实上，一位非人格主义的一元论者，他们不接受神的存在。
They don't believe that you should only worship God.
他们并不相信人只要去崇拜神。
And they don't believe the living entities are all His servants.They think God and the devotees are all on the same level. And they think in the material world they're different, but once they're liberated, they all become one. So these people, these monists, they think that devotional service is just some material activity. And they think if you do these activities of devotional service, you'll get karma. So this is a big obstacle in devotional service.
那么这种观点是做奉爱服务的一个巨大的障碍。
So this discussion between Advaita and Nityananda is to give instruction to all the devotees.
啊，对的，差人和尼提安南达之间的这个讨论，实际上是对所有奉献者都是一个巨大的警示。
Lord Nityananda wants to show everyone.That Advaita Acharya is not a monist. He doesn't agree with the monist philosophy.
Nityananda 想向所有的人指出来， Advaita Acharya 他并不是一个原论者。
According to the scriptures, the absolute truth is Brahman, Paramatma, and Bhagavan.
根据经典。绝对真理是饭、超灵、国家饭。
So this is different from the monists. The monists they just say only Brahman.
这和一元论者的哲学有天壤之别。一元论者认为只有 Brahman， 只有饭。
So Advaita Acharya, he is called Acharya.Because he was teaching bhakti, he was spreading the bhakti teachings.
Advaita Acharya, 所以称为 Acharya, 宗师，因为他在传播 bhakti 奉爱。
He wasn't teaching monism, Mayavadi philosophy.
他并没有在教导 Mayavadi 假象宗的一元论哲学。
So.Advaita, the philosophy of monism or oneness is oneness in variety, it can be oneness in variety.
Oneness,
how to understand that? Oneness, that there's oneness, but there's difference, there's variety. Yes. Monism teaches.
Yes.
Monism teaches oneness, but it's not oneness that without variety, it's oneness with variety.
Oh, okay. 并不是没有没有种类的，就是单纯的一元，相反它是涵盖着各种各样的，就是丰富多彩多姿多彩的里面多姿多彩的这种一元。
So the Vaishnava conclusion is given in the Bhagavatam.
Vaishnava 的结论不是圣典博伽瓦坛就说了 Vaishnava 的结论。
That you have oneness in the sense that there's the Lord and the living entities, they're one in the sense that they're both Brahman, but there's a difference. There's variety.
那么这个一元呢，就可以这样理解，就主和生物体呢，他们在本性上他们都是 Brahman， 他们都是梵，但是他们二者是有区别的，因为有着各品种多样的多姿多彩的种类。
So we accept, we can accept impersonalism.We can advise. We accept that the Lord has his impersonal feature, right? We can speak about the impersonal, the Brahman. It's one aspect of the Absolute Truth.
We also accept the non-personal feature, right? Because the non-personal feature is also the Lord.也是绝对真理的一个方面，一个特征。
But it's not limited to that. There's also the Paramatma feature, then there's the Bhagavan feature.
但是绝对真理并不局限于它的非人格的梵的特征，绝对真理它还包括了超灵的特征以及薄伽梵、八个梵、薄伽梵的特征。
And of course, Krishna is the.Bhagavan, he's the original Supreme Personality of Godhead.
Krishna, 那是薄伽梵 Krishna 是最原初的那位至尊性格神手。
So he's one with everything, but at the same time he's different.
所以 Krishna 和万事万物在质上是一样的，但是他又跟他们有区别。
Krishna performs many different activities, and these activities are they're all spiritual.
Krishna, he can perform many different activities. All these activities are on the spiritual level.
There's the power and the powerful. So Krishna is the powerful, and the power, that's all the different living entities.
有能量和有能量拥有者 ，Krishna 他是能量拥有者，生物体是能量。
So within the powerful, there's many varieties. There's all different varieties of living entities.
所以在能量拥有者，在能量拥有者中呢，有各式有品种。不同的品种，这些不同的品种就是生物体。
We have to understand there's difference. We're not all the same. We're all one. We're all living entities. We're all parts of the Supreme, but we're individuals. So there's a difference.
所以我们要明白，这是有区别的，是不一样的。生物体是绝对真理的所属部分，但是它们都是个体的。
有了，
这怎么就有了又？
不是，刚才就是那个设置里头，我都点成，有了。
这里还是知道荣耀 play 活力，请您听一下，好，谢谢。
So the devotees will never support what the Mayavadis teach.
奉献者，他们永远不会支持假象宗的哲学的理论。
We have to understand the difference. between these two philosophies.
所以我们一定要区分这两种哲学之二者之间的区别。
So Advaita Acharya, Lord Nityananda was defeating this Mayavadi philosophy by speaking about Advaita Acharya.
Nityananda 通过这样赞扬阿对达赤亚，他就打败了这个 Mayavadi 假象中的哲学理论观点。
The devotees accept Krishna as the ultimate supreme lord.
奉献者认为 Krishna 是终极的至尊者，至尊主。
And if there's no Krishna, then it's all Maya. But it's not actually real.
、
there's no Krishna, then it's just Maya.
Okay.
Then Maya means something which has actually no reality. It's not real. It's illusion.
Maya 幻象就意味着它不是真实的，它都是幻象。
So when we become Krishna conscious, then we can see the distinction between the material nature and the spiritual nature.
我们具有 Krishna 知觉之后呢，才能看到这二者的区别，看到物质自然、物质本性和灵性本性、灵性自然的区别。
We can see they're actually not different, although in conditioned life we think they're different.But when we become fully Krishna conscious, we'll see there's no difference between the material and the spiritual energy.
实际上，物质能量和灵性能量呢，它们两个是没有区别的。但是在受条件限制的状态下，在我们受条件限制的眼中呢，是看到它们是有区别的。但是实际上，它们二者没有区分。
Prahlad Maharaj, he saw everything as one. He saw everything as, he saw Krishna everywhere.
Prahlad Maharaj, he saw everything as one. He saw everything as one.
He sees everything in relation to Krishna. So everything is spiritual.
He saw everything as one.Krishna 是有联系的，所以在他眼里，万事万物全都是灵性的。
So Advaita Acharya, he has glorified devotional service.
Advaita Acharya, 他荣耀了奉爱服务。
And Lord Nityananda, he condemns the Mayavadi philosophy.
而 Nityananda 谴责了。Mayavadi 假象中的哲学理论。
And he says the great philosophy is the teachings of Advaita Prabhu. The correct philosophy is what Advaita Acharya says.
Okay. Nityananda 说，Advaita Acharya 所说的话是正确的哲学理论。
So Lord Nityananda then says to Advaita, you are a monist.
然后接着呢 ,Nityananda 就对主Advaita Prabhu 说，你是一个一元论者。
And I am eating beside you.
而现在呢，我就坐在您旁边在这里吃饭。
So I don't know how my mind will be affected by this.
我就不知道我的心意会因此受到什么样的影响了。
So, as devotees, we also have to be very careful about where we go and who we eat food with.
身为奉献者，那我们就对于我们去哪里和谁坐在一起吃饭地点呢，我们就要小心。
One householder devotee came to Lord Chaitanya, and he asked him.What should be the proper behavior of a devotee?
有一位居士奉献者来找主凯坦尼亚，向他询问说，那一位奉献者他的恰当的行为举止应当是如何的呢？
And Lord Chaitanya told him that devotees should give up the association of people who are not devotees.
而柴坦尼亚就告诉他们说，一位奉献者应当放弃非奉献者的联谊。
So we have loving relationships, just like accepting prasadam and offering prasadam, that should be with devotees, not with non-devotees.
我们跟别人也有一种爱心相交流，比如说给予prasadam，接受给予，但是这种交流应当是跟奉献者之间进行的，而不是和非奉献者之间进行的。
And we shouldn't take food from non-devotees, especially food prepared in restaurants or hotels or airplanes.
我们不应当接受非奉献者所烹制的食物，不应当从饭馆、旅店和飞机上接受这些地方的食物。
So the idea is we should not eat with Mayavadis because they're not devotees.
要点就是不要和假象宗持假象宗观点的人，跟这些非奉献者不要接受他们的食物。
So in this way, Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda and Advaita, they were talking with each other and they were actually praising each other.
这样，尼提亚南达和阿维塔查亚他们在交流着。实际上呢，他们所说的话是在赞扬对方。
But it appeared like they were calling each other bad names.
但是呢，表面上好像他们在谩骂对方。
So then Lord Chaitanya was calling all the devotees to come and take prasadam, and they were distributing prasadam, and they were chanting the holy name.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he called all the devotees to come and take prasadam. He gave them prasadam, and they gave the holy name.
And they gave everyone flower garlands and sandalwood pulp.
给每个奉献者花环，也给他们涂上檀香浆。
And then all the people who'd been distributing prasadam, then they sat down to take their prasadam.
那些派发 prasadam 的奉献者们，随后他们也坐下来开始荣耀了，给予 prasadam.
And then Govinda, Lord Chaitanya's servant, he kept some food, and he went to take it to Haridas Thakur.Some of Lord Chaitanya's remnants were distributed to the devotees, and they kept a little to give to Haridas Thakur.
Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的一些 prasadam 派给了奉献者，还有少量的就留给了 Haridas Thakur.
So this is Lord Chaitanya's pastime.Of cleaning the Gundicha temple. And after they cleaned the temple, then the next day is the Rathiyatra festival. So everyone was very happy because for 2 weeks they had not seen Lord Jagannath.But now, the 2 weeks is over, and Lord Jagannath is coming and going to have Rath Yatra.
现在两周的时间终于过去了，他们马上就要见到 Jagannath 了。
So they all went to the temple to see the deities in the temple.
他们都蜂拥涌到了庙里去觐见主。
And Lord Chaitanya was surrounded by all of his devotees, they all wanted to protect Lord Chaitanya from all the people, because many people all wanted to touch Lord Chaitanya, but all his servants would stand around him to protect him.
不见者们,庙里有很多的人,他们都想触碰主柴丹亚。主柴丹亚的仆人们都围着他身边,保护着他,不让别人触碰他。Yeah,
and they're so eager to see Lord Jagannath. People didn't worry about the regulated principles, and they were all pushing and shoving to see Krishna. They wanted to get in to see the Lord. Now, Lord Chaitanya couldn't get a place in the temple room. He had to go into the place where they offer the food to Lord Jagannath. So Lord Chaitanya was very eager to see Lord Jagannath because he hadn't seen him for 2 weeks. So he was like a bumblebee trying to drink the honey from the lotus flower. Lord Chaitanya usually would stand at the back of the temple beside the Garuda Stamba, and he would stand there and see Jagannath. But today, because there were so many people, Lord Chaitanya had to go near to another place. He had to stand in the place where they offer the food. So that, seeing that Lord Jagannath is freshly painted, so his face is very beautiful and his eyes are very bright, so the devotees are in ecstasy to see Lord Jagannath. But Lord Chaitanya would be in ecstasy, his body would be trembling and tears would be coming from his eyes. And when they came to offer the food for Lord Jagannath, then Lord Chaitanya would do kirtan for Lord Jagannath. But it came time for Lord Chaitanya's lunch, so the devotees told Lord Chaitanya, "You should come now, come and take prasadam." So they knew they were going to have the Rath Yatra festival. So all the devotees, they were making big offerings. They would offer much more because they knew it's going to be a long day. So tomorrow we'll go on and we'll talk about the dancing of Lord Chaitanya in the Rath Yatra festival.
明天呢,我们就会继续,我们的课程会继续讲,如柴丹尼亚在寒车节上翩翩起舞。
All right, are there any questions?
Yes. 现在呢?
Yeah.
这个问题是有一些,一个问题来自于徐小渊的问题, Hare Krishna, 顶拜Guru,顶拜您,上午, Guru 讲到, 我们要让别人接近 Krishna, 而不是远离, 我们需要和别人交朋友, 而不是树敌。 亲爱的 Gurudev, 我的问题是, 我发现自己在不熟悉的人面前很难放松,很紧张, 会让人不舒服, 我该怎样改善这个状态呢? 感谢Guru。 So this question is from Xu Xiaoyuan. He said, in the morning you mentioned that we should let others to approach Krishna and not to let others make the, keep some distance with Krishna. We should make friends with others and not to make them our enemy. So dear Gurudev, my question is that I found that in front of people I'm not familiar with, I will feel very
shy.
Nervous.
Nervous.
I cannot relax very easily.
Mm.
And that will make others very uncomfortable. So how can I change this?
Hare Krishna, Xu Xiaoyun. Thank you for your question. Yes, we understand that it's a bit difficult for you to be with people who you don't know and you feel nervous, but you'll get used to it. You know, I used to be like that also when I was a new devotee. When I was a new devotee and people would come to the temple, then devotee would say to me, talk to the guests. And I wouldn't know what to say to the guests, and I felt, I was just a new devotee, I felt uncomfortable, I didn't know what to say to people. But gradually you just get used to it, you know, you just keep trying and you'll forget about it. Because you'll put aside the nervousness and you'll just understand, you know, okay, it's not a big thing.
Hare Krishna， 非常感谢您的问题。知道，跟不熟悉的人在一起呢，就有点困难，就会感到紧张。但是慢慢就熟悉了，就是比如说，当我还是年轻的新奉献者的时候呢，人们就会来到庙里头，然后奉献者呢就会跟我说，让我让姑姑跟一些人谈话。但是当时呢，我也不知道该跟他们说什么好。然后我，那么在跟新人在一起的时候呢，我也感到不舒服，我都不知道该怎么说话。但是慢慢的就习惯了，就不见得去尝试跟他们说话，去努力的尝试着跟他们说话。然后慢慢的呢，就把这些紧张情绪呢，就给抛到一边，然后
Just like the story, Prabhupada tells the story about the young girl, she's trained to dance, you know. And so when it comes time for her to give a performance on the stage, you know, and all the people are in this audience and her family and her relatives have all come to watch her dance, and she's got to dress up, she's got to go out there to as a dance, and she has to wear, you know, the clothes, whatever dress the dance wears. So she feels uncomfortable, she feels nervous, she feels, oh, I have to dance in front of all these people, oh. But she's a dancer, she's been trained to dance, so she should just dance, and don't worry about it.
We have to
understand more that we're not the body. But problem is the nervousness is coming because you're thinking you're the body. But you're not the body. You're the soul in the body. You're not the body.
我们要明白，我们不是这个躯体，这紧张情绪是来自于，就是我问题就，因我们之所以紧张，因为我们认为这个躯体就是我们自己，但实际上呢，我们是居住在这个躯体当中的。
So you just have to keep reminding yourself, I'm not this body, I'm a spirit soul. I'm the same as everybody else.
要不断地提醒自己，我不是这躯体，我是灵魂，我跟别人都一样。
So you have to overcome this. This is just, you know, this nervousness, this shyness, this doesn't have to be like that. You can overcome it, just put it aside. Just chant Hare Krishna, and you'll forget about it.
你要克服就这个紧张的害羞的这种心理哦，把它放到一边，把它放送 Hare Krishna， 把它忘掉。
So you have to take more shelter of the holy name. You have to hear more carefully the holy name, and will help you to overcome this nervousness.
你要脱避于圣灵，你要小心的聆听圣灵，这样呢能帮助你克服紧张的心理。
Yes.
那我们看下一个是来自 Yuna 的问题。Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisance. O Lord, to Srila Prabhupada, is envy of Krishna the cause of dirt in the heart? Dirt in the heart? Yuna 就是说 Hare Krishna, 你接受我卑微顶拜，荣耀归帕帕的问题是，对 Krishna 的嫉妒是不是内心的
污垢
的根源呢？
Oh, the thing is envy in the heart, the root cause of what?
Dirt, D-I-R-T, dirt.
Oh, okay. Well, envy, we say two things, there's desire and envy.Icha and Dvesha. Icha, desire, we want to be Krishna. And Dvesha, we're envious of Krishna, we hate Krishna.
Icha means we want to be Krishna. Okay. 所以有两件事，一个是 Icha, 一个是 Dvesha. Icha 就是我们自己，就我们想自己当 Krishna.自己做神，还有 Dvesha 就是我们，we envy Krishna, right?
We hate.
Oh, hate. Okay. Dvesha 就是我们憎恨 Krishna.
Yeah, we want to be Krishna ourselves.
我们自己就想，取代 Krishna, 成为 Krishna 的地位。
So we're trying to compete with Krishna.
我们就是在跟 Krishna 竞争。
We want to be the supreme. We don't want Krishna to be the supreme. We want to be the supreme.
我们想做那个至尊者，我们不希望 Krishna 做至尊者，我们希望我们自己成为至尊者。
Krishna is the best friend, but we're thinking I am the best friend.
Krishna 是最好的朋友，但是我们却想，我才是最好的朋友呢。
OK， 还有问题吗？
下一个问题是 Krishna Kumar。Krishna Kumar 说：“明白 Guru 和奉献者们，请问 Guru 如何分辨心意的正确？比如自己研读经典。”与新人分享经典，内心的喜悦和动力源源不绝。当履行家长的职责，被学校要求学习一些正能量的课程，内心是不认可的，想回避。在一起。 些奉献者办的培训课程中，对以服务为名的冗长程序内心是想拒绝的，只想听课和其他服务，不想浪费时间是在刷手机上，被说成是不臣服。我的问题是，怎么分清当下是自己带着智性的知觉，是按本有的属性走自己的路，走他人的路很危险，还是这是假我的骄傲等需要被清理的心意呢？Krishna Kumar said, obeisance to Guru and all devotees. So Guru, how to distinguish whether my mind is correct or not?
For example, my mind is what?
Correct.
Okay.
For example, I read scripture. When I read scripture, or I sharedtopics about scripture with neophytes, the bliss and the inspiration in my heart is perpetual. There will be constant bliss and inspiration in my heart. But when I have to carry out my duty as parents, and the school asked me to learn some course of positive energy course. My mind wants to evade this course. My mind do not accept those course. And when I attend some training course by devotees, there are long procedure in this course.In the name of service, my heart wants to reject it. I only want to listen to hear lecture and do other service. I do not want to waste my time in the cell phone. But they said that this is not surrendering. My question is that how to distinguish whether in the presence I am my consciousness is whether at the present moment I'm doing my duty according to my guna with the correct consciousness, or I'm doing others' duty, I'm following others' path. Because in Bhagavad Gita it is said that if one do one's own duty, because it is very dangerous to follow in others' path. Or is this due to false the pride out the pride from the false ego? My mind need to be cleared. Can you understand?
Yeah, I think so. Yes, well.How do you know what your duty is? Well, you have to remember you're a mother, you have children, you have a duty to them. So you have, you know, if the school asked you to take on some positive energy course, which is good for parenting, then this is something which is actually related to your situation, because you are a mother.You have children.
那 Krishna Kumar, 因为您是母亲，您有孩子，那么作为母亲呢，她有自己的职责， 学校要求您去参加正能量的课程，需要父母去学习这个课程。那么这个课程呢，事实上是跟就做父母、身为人母是有关系的，因为有毕竟是有孩子。
You may feel this is all mundane material knowledge, it's not very relevant for you. You would rather sit and hear Krishna conscious katha. That's very good, very nice. But sometimes, you know, you have to do things, material things. You have some responsibilities in the material world, and sometimes you have to do these things just because you have that commitment in the material world. You're not fully liberated yet from all of this responsibility.
那么就是您可能会觉得都是世俗的，跟您也没关系，还不如去听一些 Krishna Katha Krishna 的话题好吗？但是呢，有的时候呢，您也得必须去做一些物质的事情，去履行物质世界的职责，因为呢，您有。你有您在物质世界的职责要履行，您需要去承担这个作为母亲的这个责任。因为在物质世界，你需要承担这个责任，而且就是您就是还没有对于一个完全没有解脱了的，还没有完全解脱的，没有解脱的情况下呢，必须要履行责任。
So sometimes you have to do these material things, you have to take on these material duties and just do it and finish it and then come back to your real business, which is Sanatan, which is spiritual, which is in relation to Krishna consciousness.
那在履行完您的那个物质的职责之后呢，做完之后呢，您就完事之后赶紧回来做您的那个 Sanatan 的职责。
Of course, if you can avoid it, then okay, avoid it. Don't go. Don't sit. Don't waste your time and sit in here. Useless, mundane, material knowledge.
If she can avoid it, then she should avoid it.
Yeah.
Okay. 那如果Krishna Kumar您能够避免的话。不去听的话，那就避免好了。那还是听灵性的话题好了。
Yeah. Why should we waste our time?
因为我们为什么要浪费时间呢？
You have your duty to Krishna. You have so many things to do for the service of Krishna.
因为我们对因为您有对 Krishna 的职责，您对 Krishna 有那么多服务要做呢。
But you have to be careful not to be neglectful about any responsibilities which you may have in the material world.
与此同时，您千万不要忽视，就是在物质世界的履行责任这一方面，不要忽视自己的责任。
Devotee is not irresponsible.
奉献者不是那种不负责任的人。
Okay, is there any other question?
He said, also, in some training course by devotees, there are some course that's cost a lot of time, in the name of the service. So in her heart, she want to reject it.You want to listen to hear lecture and do service.
Causes a lot of pain in the heart.
Because this course, this training course, it needs a lot of time to learn it on the cell phone. So she felt a little bit a wasting of time, but.Then she was criticized as the attitude is not surrendering.
Well, you have to consider how important this course is. You have to consider. I don't know how important the course is, but if it's important, you know, if people tell you you should do it, yeah, then you have to do it. It takes time, but you have to do it. Just like devotees are doing courses like Bhakti Shastri course, these things, it takes time. It takes time, but it's very important. It's very valuable.
那么您就要看衡量这个课程是不是重要的，那如果这个课程是重要的，你被告知必须要去学习，那么这些课程确实是要花时间，比如说奉爱经典的课程呢，就需要大量的时间，但是这个奉爱经典的课程它是很重要的，很有价值的。
So be careful. Don't just give up. Don't just become irresponsible and give up things. You think, oh, it's too much trouble. I'm not going to waste my time. You may think it's a waste of time, but later on you may have to do it. So you should do it and get it done with.
就是不负责任，不要放弃，不要嫌麻烦，就是你把这些放弃掉。那虽然浪费时间，现在浪费时间，但是你以后呢？后来你可能还得必须要面对它，必须要去这么做。那么就该做的事，那就还是做好吧。
Just like doing things like going to university, taking a degree, then doing a master's or something, PhD, these things, sometimes people think, oh, too much trouble, but then later on they regret that they never did it.
就像上大学，然后要取得学位，之后呢还要去读硕士，再读博，有的是人们就会觉得很麻烦。
So be careful.
那您这个就需要谨慎。OK。那Krishna Kumar这个回答没回答您的问题。 如果没有的话，您再去问。下一个是Novel， 顶拜亲爱的Guru Deva， 顶拜所有的Vaishnava， 请问Guru Deva， 什么样的 Prasad 是一流的 Prasad？
Oh yeah, first class Prasadam is Prasadam which is cooked by a nice pure devotee and which is offered by a pure devotee.
一流的 Prasad 是 由那些优秀的、内心纯净的奉献者所供制的，继而又由那些优秀的、内心纯净的奉献者供奉的 prasada。
Okay.
Krishna Kumar said that this course, because she herself has the degree of education degree like that. She had learned how to become a teacher for many years, and this course is about the second initiation.
Well, the course is for the second initiation.
Yeah.
Well, if she's thinking about second initiation, then she has to do the course. It will be better for her to do the course.
如果您想要得二次启迪的话，那您就需要上这个课。Okay,
go ahead.
好，下一个是来自于 Servant。 哦，没了。Okay, no question anymore.
Okay, so 我们今天讲到这儿。 感谢 Guru Mani 给我们翻，精彩的翻译，感谢所有的奉献者聆听。 谢谢你们的问题。 我们明天见。Hare Krishna, Srila Prabhupada Ki.
Thank you, Maharaj. 非常感谢，嗯 ，Maharaj 给我们带来精彩讲课。感谢所有奉献者的聆听和好问题。Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.